हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम डॉक्टर प्रदीप जैन. आई एम द डायरेक्टर ऑफ जीआई कैंसर्स एंड जीआई सर्जरी इन फोर्टिस हॉस्पिटल शालीमार बाग दिल्ली. टुडे वी विल टॉक अबाउट जीआई कैंसर्स. बिफोर टॉकिंग अबाउट जीआई कैंसर्स, वी शुड नो व्हाट इज जीआई ट्रैक्ट. जीआई ट्रैक्ट इज अ सिस्टम विच इज इन्वॉल्व इन डाइजेशन, एंड द स्ट्रक्चर्स विच आर बिलोंगिंग टू जीआई ट्रैक्ट आर इसोफेगस, दैट इज कॉल्ड फूड पाइप, stomach, small intestine, large intestine, liver and pancreas. So cancers can involve the entire body and GI part is not no exception. GI cancers are one of the leading cause of death in the world. So it is very important to know the cancers of GI tract, detect cancers and to how to prevent them. So when we are talking about GI cancers, the cancers can be in the esophagus, stomach, small intestine, large intestine, liver and pancreas. The common symptoms of GI tract cancers are the difficulty in swallowing, the having blood in the stools, or there is any distension of the abdomen, or any lump in the abdomen, or unnecessary weight loss or fatigue. So if we have these kind of symptoms which are persisting for a long time and not getting remedied by a general practitioner, so in these cases we can get a checkup from the specialist, and there are certain tests by which we can detect whether there is a cancer or not. So the common tests done are endoscopy, CT scan, MRI and PET scan. These are the common tests done to diagnose GI cancers and to know the stage of GI cancers. These cancers can be treated by many methods. The three main methods are surgery, chemotherapy and radiotherapy. The surgery can be done by open method, that's a conventional method, or it can be done by a minimally invasive technique which can be either laparoscopy or robotic. So all these methods can be applied in different cancers in different stages. It is not necessary that this will be treated by only one method. The all three methods can be combined to treat the surgery, treat the cancers. Like in food pipe cancers, if the cancer is gone beyond stage 1, then it can be treated by chemo and radiation before surgery. We do the chemotherapy, radiotherapy, wait for 6 to 8 weeks, then we do surgery. Same way in rectal cancers, in early stages we go for straight away surgery. In later stages, like in stage 2 or 3, we like to go for chemo radiation, that means chemotherapy and radiotherapy before surgery, and after waiting for 6 to 8 weeks we can go for surgery. Simultaneously, similarly, in other organs also, like liver cancers or pancreatic cancers, the different methods can be applied in different stages. So talking about the cancer surgery, the laparoscopic and robotic surgery is the in thing. It has many advantages when we are doing as compared to conventional surgery. In minimally invasive surgery, after the surgery, the patient is much more comfortable as compared to the open surgery. Like the early recovery, less pain, less blood loss, and early back to work. These are the advantages of minimally invasive surgery. That's a laparoscopic surgery. The robotic surgery and laparoscopic surgery is almost same. The only difference is when in laparoscopic surgery, the surgeon is just standing on the table besides the patient, and in robotic surgery, surgeon is sitting somewhere else and the robotic arms are operating and the surgeon is handling the robotic arms. Overall, there is no difference in comfort to the patient in robotic or laparoscopic surgery. The only thing is robotic is slightly costlier, laparoscopic is cheaper, the results are same. And whether you do robotic surgery, laparoscopic surgery or open surgery, overall cancer results are same. The only difference is early recovery in minimally invasive technique.